recognition of the symbols. She said that it's like a statement of the plan for any part of the country. Then in 1988, Newman believed that curriculum is a wider term as compared with symbols. Curriculum covers all the activities and arrangements made by the institution throughout the academic year. However, the curricular, the syllabus is limited to a particular subject of a particular class. So we can see that the syllabus is part of the curriculum and is made based on the curriculum. So how the syllabus developed, let's have a look at its evolution. After Chomsky created the generative grammar, at that time most teachers focused on teaching grammar. So this is why the first kind of syllabus produced at that time we call the structural syllabus, which is focused on linguistic structures and words. Then in the middle to late 1960s, some linguistics were aware of that we shouldn't over emphasize on structural competence. When we teach a language, we should focus on its functions. At that time, the notion of function syllabus occurred. In notion of function syllabus, the content is not arranged based on the formal structures of language. They just arranged based on the functions. So this is why the communicative syllabus is created. And now we still use the communicative syllabus. So let's have a look at the clarification of the syllabus. So at the beginning, there is the traditional syllabus, which focuses on linguistic structures and words. And then, the semantic syllabus appear. There are three types, situational, notional, and functional. And now, what we use is communicative syllabus. So, how to design a communicative syllabus? Firstly, we'll look at the left side of the form. In 1918, Adams divided three levels of communicative competence. Level 1 is elementary, level 2 is intermediate, and level 3 is advanced. So in level 1, for teachers, they should focus on language structures. So at this time, we can use some structural syllabus to teach students. Then when students make progress on their language learning, teachers can change their orientation, and they need to make some functional syllabus to help students facilitate their communicative competence. And finally, if the students reach the level 3, the advanced level, they should use the authentic language to communicate with others. At this time, teachers should combine the syllabus in level 1 and level 2 to make a complicated communicative syllabus. So there are three stages in designing a communicative syllabus. Firstly, we need to do some survey to know the course we will teach and clarify our purpose of this class. And then we will choose the most suitable syllabus for students. There are several syllabus for students in terms of their levels. The syllabus I will analyze in a high school is in grade 1, in the semester 1 of grade 1. So there is the structural syllabus I will analyze. Let's have a look about the syllabus. So we can see the left side is the timetable. Totally, there are 20 2 weeks in a semester, and the last 2 weeks are examination. For the teachers, they need to teach the contents about 18 weeks in this semester. And the middle part is the teaching contents. They are all the grammar points students need to learn. And one thing we need to notice is that the observations, because in this school there are more than 20 classes in a grade, and these classes are divided into three levels, A, B, C. And A is the advanced levels. For some students, these contents are quite easier. Maybe the teacher will teach more faster than other classes, but if they finish in the teaching tasks in advance, they cannot arrange any new content of next semester. What the teachers need to do is that they should arrange some relevant materials or exercises for students to improve their language skills.
So how the syllabus
is designed, some of the parts are based on the textbook. So now let's have a look at the contents of the textbook syllabus. As we can see, in this semester there are two books the teachers need to finish. And you can see the grammar part. Some we have seen in the syllabus, but not all the teach contents are in the syllabus. Then here is the writing part. When students finish their grammar part, they will move on to the function of the language. And finally is the communicative language. So we can see that the textbook is also based on the communicative content. So let's make a comparison between textbooks and the syllabus. So here we can see in the first 4 weeks, the contents don't appear in the textbook. So for these contents, they are based on the curriculum we will see in the next slide. But we can see the sequence in the syllabus is quite different from the textbook. Here we can see in the textbook, the grammar point attributive clause it is on the first unit and last unit of textbook 2. However, in the syllabus, arranged them together and put the sequence of passive voice after the attribute clause. And this is the curriculum of English teaching of the high school in China. So we can see the read part, the teaching objectives and the basic skills. From the requirement of the curriculum, the school also arranged some phonetic study to improve students' notation so that they can utilize phonetics and notation to express meaning. This is why the first 2 weeks, all of the students have to learn the phonetics. And then in the writing part, students need to probably use grammar, letters, and functions. We know that learning how to write accurately is a long process for students. So they have to practice at the grade 1. This is why they need to know some contents of the sentences so that they can write accurate sentences. So let's make a conclusion about the syllabus analysis. So for teachers, it's really difficult to design a communicative syllabus. So they need to know the stages I just mentioned in the introduction to make a proper syllabus for students. And for the syllabus I analyze, it's just the structure. structural and functional, it's just the structural syllabus. Based on the requirements of the curriculum, the syllabus is added additional contents to develop students' learning, speaking, reading, and writing skills. So teachers can choose their own materials and make a slight change in their teaching plans. For example, for the advanced students, teachers can use additional materials to improve students' other skills like speaking and reading. And but for there is some limitations of this syllabus. It's just a grammatic syllabus which only focuses on the structures, and it's not too comprehensive that students may not improve their communicative skills. In China, there is no speaking test, so for the teachers, they only focus on the reading, writing, and listening skills, and less concentration on the speaking. This is the limitation of this syllabus. Finally, we will look at the relationship between these three elements. So as we all know, the contents of textbooks and the curriculum are hard to change. However, if we want to make our lessons more, if we want to make our lessons more appreciated for students, we need to use syllabus to combine the contents of textbook and the curriculum, and to make a teaching plan for students, which can help them improve their language skills. So the syllabus is acted as a bridge to link the textbook and the curriculum. This is why syllabus is a very significant element for teachers, and we can't ignore it. So here is my